Ladies and gentlemen, and dear friends from the SOC, it's 30 years ago that I made this film, which you have selected. It's 30 years ago that I started this film by first stepping in that submarine. It's a submarine, it was a set, but it was built like a real submarine. And I stepped in that and I saw immediately in my mind, oh, once to run with the camera through the whole ship, from one end to the other, about 150 feet long, that would be great. 30 years ago, there was no technique available to do this shot because it was not just running through the ship. That was easy, but there were the different compartments, they were separated by these emergency doors, these round, very narrow emergency doors. But how can you do this with a running camera without bumping your head, without bumping your knees or your elbows, or running even with a magazine of the camera into the walls? It was very complicated. So I went to my friends of Ari, and they built me a camera, which I sort of designed, which is this one here. And now you see, of course, it's 30 years ago, and this was the camera they had built for me. You can see it, and it was a handheld 35 millimeter camera. It was equipped with gyroscopic stabilizers, which were fixed underneath of the camera. And also what I had to have, which was not available at that time, that was a remote follow focus. But how to do this? It seemed to be just impossible. We thought about we thought about maybe we can use a cable car and have the camera floating through the ship. But how to do this, as the cable is always in frame and many people are running around the camera. So this, everything seemed to be impossible. When you really want to do something, you don't stop dreaming about it. And I realized after 3-4 weeks of shooting inside of that submarine that I got physically so much used to this surrounding. I got so much used to, I could almost close my eyes and run through the ship, because my body would know where to go. And that was finally the solution for this shot, because I just grabbed the camera and started running. When I finally made it and it finally worked, I had the feeling, wow, this is something that has never been done. Many friends from the SOC, they asked, this is impossible. How has he done it? What technique has he used? And nobody, when I told them, yes, it was pretty easy. It was physical training of myself, and it was just grab the camera and run. And don't forget about everything, just run and try to survive. To survive like the soldiers in that ship tried to survive in panic. This was maybe the best shot or the most important shot in my life. I can say this now after 30 years, and I have done so many films, and I've done so many big films in Hollywood with hundreds of millions of dollars, and I know whatever. But this shot, I think it will stay. It will stay in the film history books, and it will stay with that wonderful award, what you gave me. I thank everybody who was involved in selecting this shot as the historical shot. And sometimes I can say there might be one shot in everybody camera person's life which becomes the shot of his life, or in this case it was maybe the shot of my life. And I thank you very much, all of you have been involved, and I would say have a nice evening. Bye bye.